Okay, everybody, how's that? Can you hear me now? Let me know if you hear me now. You should be able to hear me now. Okay. Okay, great. All right. Let me briefly explain to you what happened this morning. For some reason, the company that I used to do the broadcast decided to change the membership level that I'm on, and they took away at least one of the broadcast platforms. I think maybe it was Facebook or Twitter. I initially thought that it was eliminating all of them, and of course, that's the last thing you want to happen when you're starting a broadcast, is find out that you don't know which one you're not able to use. So I decided, well, maybe I'll try one, and I did, and I went with YouTube, and that's why you're able to be here. Okay. This is the Trump Talk and Awakening live stream, and it never ceases to amaze me the things that can go wrong when I try to do this. But considering my karma and considering a lot of things that are going on in the atmosphere above us, I'm never surprised when things like this happen. And before I get into the meat of the whole thing, which is talking about what's going on with Trump and the Democratic Party, I want to bring your attention to the banner up at the top. That banner will take you to CJ's Substack newsletter, the CJ Hex Whispers of Knowing. And if you get a chance to, you may want to go over there and join that. It's free, as well as the three newsletters that I have over there as well. Mainly the one Knowing Whispers Messages from the Universe. All of this content is what our guides are sharing with us to help all of us to prepare for the volatility of the energies that astrologically are starting to move in a certain direction. And we'll know more obviously after the election. If you'd like to make a donation to this broadcast, you'll see down here below my chin, there is a link to a URL where you can make a donation for the work that we're doing here if you feel inclined to do so. Okay. All right. Yeah, Kachina, Mercury retrograde already, possibly. Okay. I would imagine that all of you feel like somewhat of a heavy burden has been lifted here lately because of the overwhelming support for Kamala Harris. And quite honestly, it is somewhat unexpected that it's this large, but it's like a tremendous burden and a tremendous relief has been lifted off of the country. Okay. But don't be totally fooled by that, because as we move into September, it'll begin somewhat here in August, but in September, October, and November, things are going to take on a different color. And no doubt MAGA and Trump will get more ruthless and dirtier in the tactics they employ. So we have a lot that we need to process as this is going on. And the most important thing is that we all keep our center while this is going on. You'll hear me talk a lot over the last year or so about the significance of karma. And without trying to say one way or the other who's going to win the election, what I can say is what is most important is that you find and you maintain your center. Okay? That will keep you from being sucked into whatever volatile energy comes up emotionally and mentally if things start to wiggle in terms of the favorability of what's going on. Okay? I will be doing some videos on that time period from now until November. And I'm doing a graphic ephemeris comparison between the chart of the US, the chart of Donald Trump, and the chart of Kamala Harris. And this will give you a sense of seeing how these are all three related and connected. Okay? And as I mentioned in my video, I think yesterday or the day before, when you are talking about Kamala Harris's chart, or any chart for that matter, whether it be that or the United States of America or maybe even Trump's, you want to take a look at the condition of the planet Uranus. Uranus rules voting. Okay? So the conditions around the voting at this election will be somewhat influenced or revealed through the condition of the planet Uranus. Okay? I mentioned in the convention, if you had a chance to watch that video, the thing that kind of surprised me because I wasn't expecting to see the aspects there of Saturn squaring and opposing several planets, and then Uranus. Both of those outer planets, you know, are not favorably aspecting a lot of the energies in Chicago on that particular day. Now, whether this will mean that there's some surprises, could be. Whether it's issues with the voting process that they have to go through, even though they are indicating that they've polled the members of the that committee, and supposedly there's enough votes for her to get the nomination. But you never know when you're looking at something like Uranus squaring, I think, three planets, and you're talking about Saturn, it opposes Venus, and I think it squares Mars and maybe Mercury. There's something about that particular day and that energy, okay, that if something happens of a surprising nature, don't be too surprised. And I guess what I'm trying to say over and above everything is don't be surprised if things kind of settle down in regards to Kamala and the momentum of the Democratic Party. Don't be surprised if things slow down because of something unexpected occurring. Something that they are not totally fully aware of, you know. I think everybody understands and knows that there is an advantage that the criminal has when it comes to any situation, and that is the element of surprise. And Trump is not dead, buried, and in the ground yet. And as long as he's alive and breathing and focused on this particular election, he will do whatever and anything he can to see to it that he has some control over it. Okay. And hey, Fonny, welcome to the broadcast. Good to see you here. I see at the moment we have 15 that are watching the broadcast, and that's always encouraging. It's nice to be able to see a lot of familiar names here that have commented and stuck with me through the last 6 to 8 years and have gotten, I think, some insight as well as some inspiration regarding what it is that's going on. Okay. I think that would probably be correct, Mooley, about the zombies. You know, there's a lot of people that are scratching their head and they're wondering what it is that these people don't see that we see about the circumstances regarding Donald Trump, okay, and regarding the MAGA group. And Dallas, welcome to the broadcast. Well, I was late this morning too, Dallas. I had another unexpected glitch in the process here of trying to get this thing going. I've mentioned many times what a challenge this is. When I go through setting up to make a broadcast, I have to check about half a dozen things to make sure they're all properly set. Otherwise, I don't get the audio, okay? Or you may not even get the video. But I think that this is probably the best way to be able to connect between me and those of you that follow the work that I do. It makes it more personable, okay, and not as secretive in a sense. In other words, I'm hiding in the background writing these things, doing videos, and I'm not here. Okay. Hey, Funny, will Project 2025 become more hidden but effective? That's a hard question. You know, one of the things I'm getting a lot of people that are asking me about certain videos to be done and stuff like that. And I have got my little box of videos is pretty full right now. I'm not only going to be doing one on, as I mentioned earlier, on the timeline between now and the election between the United States, Trump, and Kamala Harris. The charts to show the volatility periods, but I'm also going to be doing one on the Supreme Court on the election day and how they may interfere. I will say that there is an aspect in Kamala Harris's horoscope right around the election that could be an indication that the vote is put on hold for legal reasons, most likely. But there is some encouragement, okay? There is some encouragement, but there is uncertainty. And the thing about that particular group, I don't know whether or not Trump wants to audibly talk about it and support it because of the extreme measures of basically wiping out the Constitution, getting rid of the FBI and the Department of Justice. I mean, it is extremely unbelievable the things that these folks are wanting to accomplish. And this nonsense coming from Vance about, you know, giving extra votes to people who have kids. It's just so absurd and extreme that it's beyond reason. Okay, but it is, as I've been mentioning probably now for a couple of years, it's all a part of this Neptunian energy. Okay, this energy of dissolving old form. Okay, and Barbara Lynn, welcome to the broadcast. Could it have anything to do with Mogul on Trump again in October, if I remember correctly? It's possibly a combination of that, you know, that, like I was saying here a little bit ago. There are several videos that I want to focus on. One of those is on, I think, Kamala Harris, the convention, Trump in August, okay? And then several other factors that come into play, Uranus squaring his Mars, okay, I think in September, October. And then some other graphical representations that I'll share with you that kind of show what I'm talking about here. But I want to try to focus on what is current, okay? What's in the public's mind? What is in your mind about what you feel about what is going on? And then giving my take astrologically as to whether that is, you know, for, okay, the Democratic Party, for Kamala Harris, or is it, you know, against? Is it something that's going to hurt them? Okay. And again, the thing that I think I mentioned in two videos ago, that you can't forget. And this, like I said, is kind of hard to sometimes explain it this way because of the fact that when you're talking about Donald Trump, I tend to look at him in a very extreme way that goes beyond just the politics. I really see that he is, in a sense, and I'll use the word, a demonic energy, okay, that karmically is destined to have an impact, already is doing it, on the American psyche and on our values, you know. And even while we may at times deplore and abhor him and who he is, what he's doing is exposing the undercurrent of fear that exists. That is why we see what is going on, okay? It's because we have not yet solved the solution to why it is we feel kind of isolated and abandoned by divinity, by God, by the universe. Now, some of you, maybe most of you that are watching this broadcast, you're already awakening. So it's not such a problem for you. But for a lot of the masses that are running towards their savior, Donald Trump, they're looking for anything because they've been raised on greed and money as the ultimate form of happiness and salvation. And of course, you know that's not the case. All right? But this is what we're working with. This is what we're dealing with. We're dealing with fear, and even our fear, because fear is the major block to your conscious awakening. Okay? Okay, hey, funny, that's a good analogy. The trickster, the jokester, okay? So many times when I'm doing videos or I'm commenting here or I'm commenting to you in the community, sometimes it's difficult for me to say exactly what I know or what I feel because I'm not quite sure. That's why I do the poll sometimes. I want to know where my audience is within themselves. What can they accept if I talk about something, okay? Because I know these things, the way things are believed are not the way things are. I guess is the word I want to say here. Okay. And really, that's kind of what, I'm indicating here, or I'm implying. Okay. The Bible, in my experience and in my opinion, is not incorrect, but it does not reveal the totality or explain exactly how it is that we experience this inner relationship. And it was either altered over time by certain individuals or by those that interpreted the Bible, so that it only leaves kind of a suggestion or a hint, okay, about this inner relationship that we do have, that we have to discover, we have to find. Okay, and it's interesting, Muley, I'll say this much. It's interesting now when I look at the Bible. When I was a Pentecostal evangelist, of course, I had a different radical emotional approach to it. And as I moved away from that a long time ago, I began to see it differently consciously. Okay? And this will always be the challenge for everybody when it comes to what we're talking about here in regards to awakening. Donald Trump is facilitating the awakening by exposing the fear and revealing the projection of what happens to a person that can only live off of their greed, their pride, their hate, okay, and the idea that money solves all problems. These values have to change. They will be changed, okay, because if they're not changed, we're going to see the ultimate horrible outcome of making those things the god of our life. Okay. Pretty magical. That's a good word for it, okay? Now, I think, but I'm not certain I mentioned this to you the last time I did a video, at least I may have. I'm pretty sure I put it in the community section. I increased the amount of comment space that you can make in the chat window from 100 to 500. I wasn't aware that it was down at 100, which is why some of you got cut off, okay? And again, there's a reason for that. And the main reason is that if the comments get too long, then I have to stop and I have to read them, and then I have to think about them, and it cuts into the fluidity of the energy of what we're trying to do here, which is to share inner information and to get a dialogue going on, to get you to open up and to talk, okay, about your feelings, about your insights, okay? As things stand right now, I think that for everybody's sake, that spiritually, mentally, and emotionally, it's more helpful than it was a month ago, all right? But when I astrologically look at the circumstances between now going into November, I see more trouble for Donald Trump, more surprises by Donald Trump and MAGA. I see a struggling period for Kamala Harris. Okay, uncertain when it's going to start, but this is what I'll try to do when I go back and I take a look at a particular period and look at the charts and the aspects and the houses involved. Then I can kind of talk to you more about what I feel the issue is going to come up. Okay, obviously she has not encountered this type of energy, okay, totally at this level. So let's hope that her inner strength, which she does have, okay, and that Rahu on her ascendant in her Vedic chart and her Saturn in the own sign in the ninth house, let's hope that they have the same powerful influence over Trump as what we are seeing now. Because I feel, and I'm sure you probably feel the same way, that it's refreshing to see her go after Trump. I have felt for a long time that's always been a big mistake. Okay? I understand the reason for that. Okay? But somebody made a comment the other day that made me think, and it was in the community section. And I had to wrestle with it, and I'm not sure I totally don't wrestle with it at this point. as we evolve consciously, we have to release judgment. We have to release negativity. We have to accept, okay, the things in life that happen, even the things we don't enjoy, the karma, the hard karma. And we have to trust that ultimately a higher good will happen. But if that's your particular stance, and let's say you were in Germany prior to World War II, and you knew that Adolf Hitler at that time, while he was just mostly all talk, was going to be responsible for killing several million people, would you still be able, in good conscience, to not judge, totally accept, and not feel like you had some responsibility for how things could go? And of course, the most responsible way is voting. And this is why it is so important. I think it's important for Kamala Harris that she understands that we have her back going through this, particularly when it gets really dirty and ugly. Okay. All right. And that's good. Going from fear to acceptance is good, Muley. But again, going back to what I just said, none of us to this point are in absolute terror and fear for our lives. Okay? We haven't been brought to that point. All right? And other than probably quite a few people that Trump killed as a result of his incompetence with the COVID-19 thing, nothing beyond that has actually happened. But, you know, you can tell when a skunk's nearby because they smell. And Donald Trump does give off an odor, a spiritually dark odor. Okay. Hey, funny. He's so unpredictable and more dangerous now than he feels that he feels cornered. That's absolutely true. Okay. Last stage of grieving. Stay open. Micro and chicken. Okay. You might have to explain that when a little children. There you go. I thought it said chicken and you said children there, Kachinala. You know, it just goes to show you one of the benefits of being 73. Okay, Julie, welcome to the broadcast. Constantly comparing people to Hitler is such a disgrace and dishonor to Jews and the Holocaust. Yeah. There was something I got yesterday from one of my guides, too, that was interesting. And I had never felt it before, and I may not be able to remember it right now. But it had to do with a comment somebody made about the Trumpers and why they adore him, what they see in him, okay? And the only way I can explain it to you is that they suffer from the same malady as what Trump does. Because of their lack of inner spiritual fulfillment, they're seeking through their own ego and their own greed to satisfy their own sense of emptiness by what they possess. And this is how the ego deceives us, is that it makes us think that if we win something, if we do something, if we accomplish something, that we will feel whole and complete. And of course, if you've tried to do that in your life, in any area of your life, you realize that does not happen. It doesn't make any difference how much money you've got, what your title is, okay? Any of the things that you can think of desiring is not going to give you the fulfillment you're looking for. It has to come from within you consciously. It has to come from within you, surrendering your ego desires, all right? Not killing them, but not letting them control your life. Okay. And Julie, it's going to be very interesting to see what Trump's next plan is. Now, to give you a little bit of an idea here about Trump, what he's heading into this month, he's going to have Saturn opposing his Uranus. Uranus is very important to Trump. Remember, Uranus has to do with votes. It has to do with his ability to pull the rug out from underneath people. And his progressed Venus is squaring his natal Saturn. And all of this is happening while Uranus is moving back to squaring his Mars. And other people have picked up on this. that they feel like that there's possibly two more attempts on his life, possibly going into even 2025, regardless of whether he is elected president or not. So there is a tremendous amount of unexpected situations. Okay? Unexpected situations. And of course, the main thing is, how will Kamala Harris handle it when she takes a punch? Okay? She is extremely competent. She has extreme experience. She has extreme inner strength. But that's generally because you know what you're dealing with. What if something happens that she had no idea, her team had no idea it would happen? And you can bet that Trump, the people that are working for him, the inspiration he's getting from his dark energy, are all going to look for things to knock her off the fence. Okay? And maybe as a result of that, she will struggle, you know, towards the finish line. She may cross the finish line, and even though she crosses the finish line, it may be that because of what they have planned that is not known, that they tie up the election for, let's say, a few weeks to a few months. Okay? And we're all left in this suspense. Okay? If you'll remember from many of the videos I've done over the last year, I've talked about that in September and October, in the USA chart, Uranus is going to square the moon. All right? This is simply emotional vulnerability. This is the situation of something unexpected happen that's going to impact the masses emotionally. Okay? We have yet to feel the full force of the darkness of the energies that are really struggling at this point to try to take control again. But they are not gone. They'll never be gone. They are wrestling for control right now. Okay. Hey, funny, I think it is from narcissistic abuse, damage, and programming. You know, I think psychologically you can say that. But I think if you look at all the things he's been able to get away with for his entire life, the things he's getting away with now, that you have to take it above the psychological into the realm, okay, of the dark forces of the universe, okay? Now, I know that most people don't want to admit that. They don't want to admit that that exists, or that that's something which they even want to have any idea about. But if you want to continuously, consciously evolve and grow, you have to become at least aware of how the dark energy has affected you karmically. You can't ignore it, because to grow and evolve and to relieve yourself of that dark energy that is hurting you now, you have to know it exists. It doesn't mean that you have to follow it. It doesn't mean that you have to align yourself with it. It's a matter of acceptance, you know. And it's the same kind of acceptance you would think if you looked at it from a biblical standpoint, that, okay, God is good, Satan's not good, all right? God hasn't destroyed Satan. Satan still exists, all right? And I'm not saying that they actually do in that way. You know, I don't want to personify it, because it's not that simple. But so oftentimes, that's the circumstances, you know, that we find ourselves in. Okay. Conchinella, visualize her shield. Yuli, they are real. Apathetic consumers waking up to vote. I think that is very true. You know, I mean, that's the thing that when I look back on it in regards to Joe Biden's good fortune, he made the sacrifice. He sacrificed his ego for something greater. And the exalted Jupiter in his Vedic chart, which gave him really unprecedented good fortune his entire life, kind of transformed itself over into the choice of Kamala Harris. If he hadn't made that decision, would we have seen the energetic response to Kamala Harris? I mean, it is quite overwhelming. You know, the people that have come out of the woodwork have become inspired and become motivated and driven to want to work, okay, to see to it. And again, because of that, it lends me to sense that, okay, Trump's got some things hidden. He's got plan B, C, and D. He will become ruthless. He will go to no extreme. Okay. And as I mentioned in one video, I hope that the Secret Service is doing a better job with Kamala Harris than they did with him. Okay. All of these things are possibilities. Okay. And again, when I do the video, the separate videos on Trump this month, Kamala Harris towards the Democratic National Convention in September, September the 18th, Trump is supposed to be, he's supposed to be given sentence for his crimes, all right? That's going to be an interesting chart, okay? I have a sense that maybe something's going to interfere with that again, okay? So there's plenty of stuff that needs to be addressed going towards the election. So if some of you are hoping that I would do a certain video and stuff like that, don't feel bad because I said I can't really, I'm too busy, because my sense is I have to keep on top of the circumstances as they develop, or to give you forewarnings of what it is that is coming. Okay. Okay. Very possible, Muley, that she has, having dealt with criminals and things of that nature. But, and I'm sure some of you will understand this. Have any of you ever been in the presence of dark energy that no matter how strong your faith or your awareness of, you still feel like that you're in the presence of dark dirtiness? Something that just polluted your energy? Somebody mentioned the other day when they were talking about trying to understand Joe Biden in that debate, wondering whether or not something was done to him on a different level that caused him to struggle like he did. I can't say that. I mean, they gave information, you know, about him being supposedly sick. But if you've been in the presence of dark energy, you know that it can creep through the cracks in your armor and quite disrupt your focus. It's not something that you can treat as being nothing. Okay. Crystal Blue Persuasion, welcome to the broadcast. Yes. Okay. Looks like you got hit there, Crystal, by my spamming software, which had to do with putting in emoticons and things like that. Again, it's to keep the conversation clean so that we can focus on what it is we're talking about and not be distracted. Okay, Debbie, welcome to the broadcast. Good to see you here. Yeah, chaos magic. Now, I will say this much, okay? When it comes to dark energy, and I'll just talk briefly about this, it's not what you think. And the reason it's not what you think is because most people in their mind and in their imagination imagine things like Lucifer with horns or a bunch of gnomes or demons and things like this, okay? The reality of it is not quite like that. Symbolically, yeah, it describes what you feel like. But the actual energy itself is quite different, and how it can affect you is quite different, okay? What it does is that it can disrupt your conscious connection to your higher self. Okay? Much like when you go through a period of doubt, severe doubt, or where you feel like, you know, you're disconnected, or you feel like your guidance has abandoned you, you know, feelings like that that we all go through. These are the types of energies that your process of awakening is trying to strengthen you against them. The ability to be influenced by dark energy. This is why it's so important to meditate, to stay in contact with your guides and your higher self, because it gives you an insulation against the impact of surprising dark energy attacks. Okay? So keep that in mind. Okay? The deeper that you go into your relationship with your guides and the higher self, the more you'll begin to understand with a more purer understanding the nature of dark energy. Okay, let's see. Crystal, it was because you used too many emoticons. Okay, I hope you don't take that offensively, Crystal. It's designed to try to keep the focus on the conversation as it's going. Because the more that you put the emoticons and other things in and too long of comments and stuff, it makes it harder for me to keep up with everybody's questions, comments, and things like that. So we have to do that, okay? I know that it can seem like it's an inconvenience in a way, but it has a purpose, and I have to work with it. Okay, Debbie, see, this is not an election in a traditional sense. It's about love versus hate and about freedom versus control. Okay? And for those of us that are here, we understand that. Those of you that have been with me for so long, you understand that. You understand the depth of that. However, and I'm going to say this, however, all right, I'm going to throw something out here to you. The single most important thing that you need to do besides your vote is take advantage of this time to draw closer to your inner guidance and your higher self. Because this particular situation is not just a matter of voting. It's also a matter of karma. And karma trumps voting. Okay? And I don't know whether or not Trump will trump this voting. All right? But I have to look at it from a karmic situation because that's what I've been taught. That's what I've learned. Okay, that the unexpected can happen, you know, and if you try to say that, you know, evil can't do something horrible, horrific, World War I, World War II, millions of people died, COVID, millions of people died, okay, and the only guard you have against the dark impact of that is to make a breakthrough consciously into your higher conscious self. Where you begin to see the truth as the higher self and the universe views it from a non-emotional karmic point of view, okay? That'll shield you against any outcome, even though an outcome with Trump would really be horrific, okay? But Trump's day's coming, okay? Sooner or later, it's coming. Okay, thank you for that interjection there, Debbie. We have about 15 minutes left. Is there any questions in particular that you want to ask about the astrology between now and November or comments about how you're doing? I noticed the last couple of days, I don't know if everybody felt this, but the last couple of days, I felt like from a standpoint of my higher self guidance and my ego issues that I still work through, that I felt more polluted by my ego issues than I did by a sense of being at rest with my higher self. So have any of you begun to feel like this wave, so to speak, of maybe having to look at things in your life that you had thought were done? Okay. And Cece, welcome to the broadcast. Okay. Let me know what you think. Middle East getting crazy. Yes. Okay. All right. You know, it is particularly difficult to accept, to trust, and to not judge when you have a feeling that your emotions and your negative state of mind is stronger than your awareness. But I can say this from personal experience. You will go through cycles of that. You'll go through cycles when you'll feel an absolute crystal clarity consciously of knowing who you are, why you're here, and what your life is all about, to these overwhelming feelings, emotionally negative feelings of doubt, okay, and things of that nature. And you could say that essentially our higher self is simply just cleaning up the garbage. All right. You'll have these moments where you just feel dirty, and other moments when you feel with great clarity, oh, this is who I am. This is what this is all about. This is why I'm here. Okay. Okay. Hey, funny. Things are better, more positive, but still reflecting on letting go of the past. Okay. Yeah, Dallas, I think that I've mentioned once before in one of the videos that the dwarf planet Eris is going to be squaring the Mercury-Pluto opposition in the USA chart for quite some time. So it's not like that everything's just going to go away. You know, even if Trump is not reelected. Okay. And again, you know, we'll just have to see the severity of how things develop. Okay, the universe always wins. True, that is absolutely true. However, because that's all there is. However, sometimes it takes us down a dark road. Okay, and even though we'd like to ignore that, we can't. Okay, Jim, welcome to the broadcast. You might be a new person. I heard from a British psychic that something would happen in the world that would cause Trump to be elected, such as Taiwan or the Middle East. You know, that's kind of, I'll say, no disrespect, Jim, but it's kind of hearsay, kind of conspiracy theory. And I've mentioned this many times before about astrologers, tarot readers, and psychics. Okay? Just because they feel a strong energy doesn't mean that they're right. Just because I believe from looking at the astrology that things may go in a certain direction doesn't mean I'm right. Okay? There are very, very few people in the world that are privileged enough or trusted enough by their higher self to reveal to them the outcome of events, because it has a horrific influence upon the imagination of people. It can cause more pain. Okay? You don't want to cause more pain. You want to make people aware. You want to give them the option and the choice and the understanding, but you don't want to imply, okay, things that you really have no control over. Okay? Because we don't. Okay? When I see a lot of things on the internet of predictions here and there and everywhere, I think one thing. The cheapening of the tools and the gifts that some are given. Okay? Because they're not really focused upon helping people to consciously evolve or to work through their karma. Okay? They're making promises and they're making forecasts and stuff of things that they have absolutely no control over the outcome. All right? So don't take that personally, Jim. It's just something that I try to caution people about. Okay. Stay childlike, open. Kachinala. Exactly. Stay open. Focusing on negative only increases the negative being focused on. That's absolutely true. Hope the VP choice is Pete or Andy. I'll tell you what. I had a feeling about Pete Buttigieg when Kathy and I were talking about the choice. I may be wrong. But I really feel, you know, like that combination there would really be a slap in Donald Trump's face, you know, you know, and again, you know, again, this is my own personal feeling like this and why I'm encouraged by what I see coming out of Kamala Harris. He needs somebody publicly to humiliate him and slap him down. If you really wanted to negate the impact, he needs to be slapped down and humbled in public. And I think that she's capable, provided that everything's on the up and up. But we know that's not going to be the case. Okay, Debbie, I'm all for Pete as VP, but I think she will pick a governor. That's a possibility. Okay. Really, you plant a seed and it grows or dies. Republicans will come for gay marriage. Okay, I'm good at we got about 9 minutes here, and I want to leave something with you to think about. Okay? Because I see this as probably the biggest hurdle that people will go through when it comes to their conscious evolution. Can you accept the fact that on some form of consciousness, on some level, that you actually are God? How do you feel about that? Does that make you feel uncomfortable? Does that sound like some kind of a blasphemous comment from a lunatic? At least think about that, because at some point in your evolution and your conscious growth and stuff, you're going to come up to a point to where you're going to look at oneness differently and how to become one with the universe. And that question will be asked to you. Okay? You'll have to look at that question and have to come to some understanding of it. Okay, Five Paces, welcome to the broadcast. How will the astrology affect our choices between now and the election? Also, how will the astrology affect the outcome after the election? I believe that we are being faced with our karma. Excellent. Absolute. Absolutely. Okay. You see, part of the process of your awakening is to bring you consciously back to the place where you begin to see yourself not as the sinner, in many cases, that you have been brought up to believe, but as the divine conscious being that you are capable of becoming. Okay? Now that doesn't give you absolute power, but it is the beginning of understanding the power you do possess and whether or not you have the humility to use it when you can. And that permission doesn't come from a psychic or an astrologer or a tarot reader. That comes from your personal relationship with your inner guidance, okay, which understands the process of becoming one. Excellent, Kachinala, oneness. Okay. Jim, I don't know. It seems like that the newspapers are against him. It all depends upon whether or not Trump feels like he is a big hindrance. And it seems like he is, but Trump would be the one. Okay. That's one way of looking at it. Hey, funny. Yeah. I think the big thing is this, and this is the way I would look at this when it comes to us becoming more godlike. We will not probably totally embrace and understand and believe that until we see a level of change within us that is so strongly severe that we realize our outer world changes. In other words, when you begin to see your awakening affect others because of the effect it has on you, then you'll begin to understand the power of your awakening and the power of love and the power of oneness. Okay? But I highly doubt that the highest form of consciousness of the universe would automatically give us all godlike powers right away because we're awake. That's not going to happen. Because we have a lot of humble learning to go through. There are things about us who are awake that we don't even know we carry with us. Baggage, prejudices, all kinds of stuff. And fortunately, the universe is compassionate enough that if we'll allow it in private, they'll show it to us so that we can deal with it without the embarrassment of realizing, I thought I was so awake, and now I'm realizing I'm not as awake as I thought I was. Okay. Possibly, Debbie, possibly. Yeah, that's very true. Our dog Riri thinks that we're gods as well, and she is happy with it. Yep, that's a good analogy, Kachinam, the monkey mind. That's pretty much what it is. It's a lower conscious identity that has served a purpose. It's given us the illusion of freedom. Okay? See, this is the one thing about Trump that I know, is that the darkness that he has embraced, the darkness that he is, ultimately will end in his own self-destruction in some way, shape, or form. That is a karmic universal principle. Okay? The light will absorb him at some point. The unfortunate circumstance, though, is that he could, with his power to persuade the imagination, this is something that I was mentioning earlier. Trump's power is over the imagination of his followers. If you can capture a person's imagination, not just their thinking, but their imagination, you will own them. He owns them because he owns their imagination. What he is thinking by what he's doing is not what they think he's doing, but he owns their imagination. Okay. That's very true. Very true, Muley. It's better to be waiting cautiously for the next humbling moment than to be imagining through your awakening what great things you're going to do. You can forget about that. If you're aware in awakening and you have gifts and talents, forget about how great you're going to be. Forget about what wonderful things you're going to do. Okay? To arrive at that point requires a certain sensitivity and humility that means that you have surrendered to your guidance and your higher self. And you know what you can and you cannot do, and what is right and what is not right to do. Okay. CC, he's brainwashed them. Exactly. Debbie, Putin signaled who he thinks will win by the hostage release. That's a very good possibility too, Debbie. Our representatives of government can be bought. This has to be ended. The oligarchs. Yeah, they have to be willing to tear down and revamp the entire structure. You know, if you were, for example, if you're building a house or you've moved into a house and you start to work on it and you find out that you have got something, some critters or whatever, running through the whole house, and you have to tear it down to build it new, you tear it down and build it new. And it looks like at this point, we got to tear down the Supreme Court. We got to tear down Congress. We may have to tear down the presidency. Fortunately, the universe is tearing down us, okay, so that we realize the consequences of what may be going on. Okay. We've come to the end of our hour. I want to read what Five Paces says here, and then I'll be probably signing off. I'm definitely saying that Trump has given people permission to be their worst selves. Harris, being the proposed president, is bringing out hidden biases and prejudices in the love and light community. And that's true. That's true, too. There are many things, again, karma cuts to the bone. Okay, karma cuts to the bone, and sometimes we are unconsciously not only walking in our ignorance, but in our karma. And the events that go through our life, the hard events, difficulties, sickness, the deaths, the failures, the losses, and things like that, all of those things, you have a choice. You can hate life, you can hate your life. You can believe you've been unfairly treated, or you can accept the fact that you needed that loss. You needed the impact of that death in your life. You needed the impact of that failure. Why? Because the only way that you can rise consciously into the knowledge of your higher self is through the utter humility of realizing how much your ego is your problem. Okay? Dallas, welcome to the broadcast. Kachinella, thank you for your conversation and your words. It's appreciated very much. Thank all of you that come to the videos and comment. I do appreciate all of you for so much of what you mean to CJ and I and the work we're doing. And we look forward to being with you throughout the entire process of everything that's going on, at least through the election. Okay. Again, thanks to everybody. And I will have this up probably sometime today for others that want to watch it from the beginning if you came in late. And we've had about 40 people today, which is the highest I think I've had of all these that I've done. And that's very encouraging. It's encouraging to know that you care enough to be here. Okay, I'm going to bow out, everybody, and I hope that you have a great weekend.